Good morning, everyone. The rain has ceased. Here's the shelter down there. Here's the ridge we slept on last night. Quite a bit of wind and some rain, not torrential downpour, but it came down. But it's 7:30, we're fixing to hike. My pack is on my back. That dry spot's where my tent was. James is just about ready, and we've got about 15 or 16 miles today, so looking forward to it. The sun has more than joined us, I think we should say. We have joined the sun, but if you can look down there and see all that white, we are definitely above the clouds that are in that valley that we look like we're descending into. It's definitely below us. You can see the peaks of some of the mountains. It's beautiful, crisp, in the 40s. Already in my shorts, it feels awesome. And we are having a wonderful morning. Look at those trees and that cloud, the sun and mountains, just glorious. Beautiful. I love to see the contrast of the morning sun or afternoon sun when it sends the shadows to one side of the mountains. You can kind of see them through these trees. Bright on one side, dark on another. It reminds me of history, what these mountains have seen and heard. Dark representing the history, the days gone by, and the bright sun representing the newness of the day and the hope of the future. To take that thought a step further, this beautiful cloud and mist that we're heading into, it's almost like the mystery of the day, the unknown. What is in today? What is a positive thing about today? And a fellow hiker's puppy dog just joined me. He's back quite a bit. He's a vet. I just came by him a few minutes ago to thank him for his service. I think I'll wait here and meet him officially because he's about 100 yards behind me and his puppy's with me. So, speaking of the mystery of today and the unknown, wow, that dog snuck up on me and was at my feet before I knew it. What a precious animal. So anyway, back to you. What's this day hold for you? It's mysterious. There's the unknown. What's in it? Look for the silver lining. You'll find it.
Girl, is your name Gracie? I think that's what he called you. Hey, there's your master. There he is coming.
There he is coming. So there goes Tonka. That's his trail name, Tonka, a good buddy of his. One of his best friends gave him that name before he left for the trail because he's tough as one of those old Tonka toys made out of metal and steel and built to last. So Tonka is planning on going all the way to Katahdin. He's a serviceman. You saw his hat. He was in submarines. And that hat and himself and a vessel he was on was commissioned in Maine way back when. He didn't give me the exact year, but way back when. And he hasn't been to Maine since that occurrence happened. And his goal is he and his puppy baby, his little girl Gracie, are going to hike all the way to Maine and return for a solemn and exciting moment of returning and remembering when. Wow, this guy's got purpose. And I'm so thankful to God for men and women in the military who've paid prices and allowed us to be out here hiking. Thank you, sir, Tonka. We tip our hat to you, sir. Now to my daughter, Hannah. Just like you love Lila, I love you. And you were always my little butterfly, right? Safely in my hands. All those years we grew up together. And I'll never forget all those wonderful years. I love you, girl. You'll always be my butterfly.
Tucked me in, turned out the light. Kept me safe and sound at night. Little girls depend on things like that. Brushed my teeth and combed my hair. Had to drive me everywhere. You were always there when I looked back. You had to do it all alone. Make a living, make a home. must have been as hard as it could have been. And when I couldn't sleep at night, scared things wouldn't turn out right, you would hold my hand and sing to me. Caterpillar in the tree, how you wonder who you'll be. Can't go far, but you can always dream. Wish you may and wish you might. Don't you worry, hold on tight. I promise you there will come a day. Butterfly, fly away. Butterfly, fly away.
Butterfly, fly away.
Got your wings, now you can't stay. Take those dreams and make them all come true.
So steps and blue gum, and we're all arriving at some trail magic. Oh my, we get to sign in, we get to, oh look here y'all, homemade cookies. We're in. What is love? Is love a feeling? Is love a choice? Is it easy? Is it hard? Is it inherent in the heart of every man and woman to be able to receive it and to give it? You think it's God himself? Is love pure, or is it tainted? I believe love is inherent in the heart of every man and woman. Every soul, every spirit, I believe, has the capability of accepting love and giving love, almost like a software update we've all been filled with that possibility. But I also believe that love is a choice. You must choose, and that choice is a key that opens up your soul, opens up your mind, your heart, your spirit, your emotions, your conscience, all of it, everything to the core of who you are, and allows you to receive and give most excellent, wonderful things, but also give and receive very painful things to most. The most painful things they will ever endure, go through, was turned by the key of love. So we choose, and then the choices of love create feelings. So of course, love are feelings created by choices, actions that we pursue. Today I want to dedicate to Hannah. my one and only child, my daughter, Annalie. You heard the song, you know that song's something special between me and you. Butterflies. You know, when you were 3 going on 4, I was 26 going on 27. And it was just me and you. And times were tough, weren't they? You know, in the process of our being together for all those years, just me and you, you found the Lord, the chief shepherd, put your trust and faith in him. Of course, I had already been saved many years ago, but we both had a lot of growth in that department, didn't we? I encouraged you and helped you, and you certainly encouraged me and helped me growing up. So those years were wonderful. I wouldn't trade them for anything. Hannah, I am your father, your dad, but I'll always be your daddy. And even though you're 27, grown, married, a child going on 2, are you kidding me? You are a very successful woman, but you will always be my little girl. I've been thinking about you all day today, praying for you and John and Lila. And I just want to tell you from the bottom of my heart how much I love you. One other thing. I've been reading Hinds Feet in High Places. I'm about halfway through, not quite halfway through, but I see you and I as the main player in the story. We're like most all of us humans have our fears, have our doubts, and fears in our lives, Hannah, have caused you and I both to make decisions that we probably regret, and then probably frozen from making decisions we wish we had have made way back when. And sometimes it seems like the Lord is just far away from us, is not answering. But that book has really been interesting in that it seems that the two guides he gives all people, according to the allegory, and I must say it tracks with my life and yours, are the guides of sorrow and suffering, because we've had our share in what we've gone through. But they're building us into people. Those heartaches, those that somewhat destruction, you might say, brought sorrow and suffering, but it's really shoring up our hinds feet and providing an opportunity for us to get with that chief shepherd, as we read in the book. And without shortcuts, but doing it his way, learning the things we need to learn so that our hinds feet can be even stronger, more skilled, so that we can reach these high places like I'm on today with more sure footing and set us up for the rest of our life. So I commit, if you will, I know it's an individual decision, but I commit, if you will, to continue to let those things in our lives that don't seem up to par or happy, joyful, etc. Those things, can we use them? Can a person use that sorrow and suffering to be their guide, to help make a better version of themselves, to take them to higher places? Absolutely. Once again, I love you, girl.
Oh, play me some mountain music like Grandma and Grandpa used to play. Then I'll float on down the river to a Cajun hideaway. Thank you.
come on, music
that comes from the heart.
Play something with lots of feeling,
'cause that's where music has to start. Oh, play me some mountain music like grandma and grandpa used to play. Then I'll float on down the river to Cajun Hideaway. Hey, hey.
Some water spaces, and doesn't look like it's very crowded. Thank you, Lord.